Hello, my name is Peter Lemmens. This is a shortened version of my creating a portable Ghidra including a Java development kit for Microsoft Windows tutorial. You can find the link to the original, long version, here. The batch file, which I create, is explained in detail in that long version. I always appreciate constructive feedback on my videos. Thank you!
Okay folks, we start by creating a folder named Ghidra, or is it Ghidra? Let's download this zipped beast and open it. And let's take a look together at the installation guide. The download finished. Let's extract it then. Here we see Ghidra requires a supported version of a Java runtime and development kit on the path to run. Interesting. It's a commercial build of GDK 15 from Oracle. Let's download that one. Okay, this seems to be easy to download. Congrats for that. Let's open a file explorer, go to the downloads. Okay, I move it to the right side so you can follow easier. Let's pick one. Normally those files are inside the folder, inside the zip archive. We will create our batch file. This batch file will ensure that Ghidra can find our Java environment. Let's save it as a batch file and we're done. Let's test it. Ta-da-da-da-da-da. Now we can create a shortcut on our desktop. Let's fix the icon and the name, of course. Okay, we're done. Copying this is really slow. Eject and we move to a new system. Let's copy and paste this. Does it work? Da-da-da-da-da. It did. Okay, perfect, we're done. So this concludes my tutorial on how to create a portable Ghidra installation which includes a Java environment. Which environment you choose is entirely up to you. Have fun and don't stop learning.